What is common between Amazon and hair transplant? You part with your money upfront and you have no guarantee of the quality of product you will get. 2 months back, I ordered 2 copies of the same book on Amazon, and as is usual, I was asked to pay upfront for ordering these books. When I received the parcel from Amazon, though I had been billed for 2 books, there was only one. Once you open the parcel, the packet you receive from the courier agency, there is no way you can prove that you received only one book, and there is no way I can get my money back. So today I have learned my lesson the hard way. I do not pay on Amazon in advance. So though the authorities, the regulatory authorities may think otherwise, in the field of hair transplant, I have nothing at all against clinics where doctors do not do the procedure themselves. For these clinics are doing a lot of great service to those hair loss sufferers who cannot afford a costly hair transplant procedure. They are doing procedures at low rates. Everyone is not fortunate to have a lot of money for a hair transplant. Hair transplants can cost an arm and a leg in many cases. Whether you are very rich or you're just a farmhand who earns just a paltry $250 a month, hair loss will affect your psyche similarly. So when these low-cost clinics where doctors do not do the procedure themselves, offer a head full of hair for a mere amount of $500 to $1,000, it does not get at my goat. It may be unethical to certain medical regulatory state bodies and downright criminal in some cases, but I see all this in another light. These clinics have made hair transplant a household name today. But what I am up against is false promises. A false promise that the doctor will do the procedure himself, charging a large amount, but then the patient ends up disappointed at the end of the procedure because the doctor was nowhere in sight. And this, mind you, is happening in 99% of hair transplants. The doctor just does not do the harvesting, which is the crucial part of a hair transplant procedure. So you just cannot discount the skills of a doctor, the skills of a person who does hair transplant repeatedly. Only then can you get consistently good results. In such clinics, besides the morality of the case, there is no continuity. One day, one team will come and operate. Another day, another team on call will come and operate in the clinic. There is no continuity. Since there is no continuity, there is no continuity of results. One patient's result might be good, and the other ones may need several revision procedures because it's a bad hair transplant. It is like a game of dice. But people are so gullible. Some are so gullible that 2 or 3 times they have been scammed. They are so gullible. And then when they come for a revision hair transplant, the donor area is completely gone. It is completely over-harvested. It's completely shocked. There is no hair available. And you just can't do a hair transplant with mere body hair. It would look so awkward. Besides, you have to carry the scars of the procedure, which are visible, besides the mental scars that the procedure left you. So if you pay in advance, there is no incentive left for the service provider to pay attention to you, to give you the quality that you deserve, to render the service as per the promise that you were given. You are a sure thing, and you can be taken care of at a very leisurely pace, at a very leisurely schedule. You become another low importance factor for these clinics, but you have paid in advance. You just cannot run away in the middle of a procedure because your grafts have been harvested. You just cannot cancel the procedure at this stage. The ball has been set rolling. So you resign at some point and the service provider gets away with subpar work. However, when a consumer is familiar with the service, when he has had the service before, he has no problem in paying upfront in advance if asked for. Clinics that insist on advance payments, even for booking a case, clinics that ask for up to 50% of the amount in advance before the patient has even reached the clinic. His procedure is still about 2 or 3 or 4 months away. These clinics are fearful of payments. And why are they fearful? Because dishonest practices, they feel themselves, attract dishonest customers. On the other hand, a compromise is paying for this procedure while you are getting the service. This is fair for both the service provider as well as the hair transplant client. Most clients today have started to insist that though they will pay 50% of the procedure cost upfront when they reach the clinic, the other 50% will be withheld till such time their harvesting and slit making has been done. This is so that they are reassured that the person who's doing the harvesting and slit making was the doctor whom they signed up for. This action legitimately protects the rights of the hair loss sufferer who is undergoing a hair transplant. After the slit making is done, that is the right time to pay, of course, because that is the time when you have the exact graft count, because one is charged per graft. This is the only way that patients today feel that they will not fall prey to the rampant scams that are proliferating all over this hair loss industry. For this industry today is no longer in the hands of doctors who stick to the Hippocratic Oath. If you have any questions you would like to ask me about costing, about hair loss in general, and hair transplants in particular, please drop a comment in the comment section below and I'll be happy to answer. Till the next video, God bless.